Hi, you're watching the ZS Prize. I am Vikas Dandekar. Our next guest is Dr. Sangeeta Reddy, who is a global healthcare leader, Indian entrepreneur, and humanitarian. She is the joint managing director of Apollo Hospitals Enterprise Limited, Asia's largest and most trusted healthcare group. She is also the president of the Federation of Indian Chambers of Commerce and Industry. Ms. Reddy is a member of the jury of the ZS Prize. What, in your view, are the critical issues or challenges of health and healthcare in India that are crying out for innovative solutions?
So this is a wide gamut. We have what has been best described in India. The healthcare system is islands of excellence in an ocean of inadequacy. So I think point number one is we just don't have enough. Not enough beds, not enough doctors, definitely not enough nurses or paramedics. The second big one I would say is that there's a critical need for us to strengthen the primary healthcare system because today, I mean, the world is talking, everybody's talking about COVID. But the fact is that this is not a pandemic, but this is a tridemic. There are three epidemics to look at, and that is the COVID epidemic, the underlying epidemic of non-communicable disease, which is truly, you know, the biggest problem for all of us. And then, and it's exasperating or making worse anyone who gets COVID, and we're seeing that data and those statistics. And then you go further to say that there is an infodemic. There's a lack of the appropriate information at the right time for people, which is very critical in, you know, in lifestyle disease. So after the inadequacy of infrastructure, the lack of primary healthcare, I would say a centralized planning and a conceptualization of where we need to go. But things have got much better on that front. I think the government, you know, is doing a great job. It's time for us now to bring public and private together to work in an integrated manner and to use the technology appropriate to actually link people. So universal health coverage, a combination of data, an improved primary healthcare system, a great improvement in infrastructure, and then finally, I think it's education and research so that we don't just have to copy solutions which are across the world, but India has the capability. We have the brain power, we have the data science, we have great doctors and nurses, and we have a very large population. We must now build India-centric solutions. And a combination of these will really create a health system that we can all be proud of.
Absolutely. Yeah, so well said, ma'am. And you actually linked me up to the next question on digital AI, the National Digital Health Mission that we are seeing, the role of big data. How do you see these as real disruptors? Because we are so, there is so, such a crying need of healthcare in the rural areas.
So actually, there's a crying need for healthcare at every level. Even urban India doesn't have appropriate healthcare. So data, data science, technology, involvement of evidence-based medicine and the right doctors to bring the correct information at the right point to people and combine that and embed it into the health system. Right. So a whole lot of data in an interview format is not what I'm talking about. But to link, you know, the critical point of care with the data on the latest care so that every doctor practices at the highest level of capability. To link operating protocols and knowledge when a nurse is at a bedside so that we minimize errors and we enhance quality. And in this whole idea of accessibility and affordability, what we need to do is to enable people so that we screen across the ecosystem, detect early, and therefore prevention becomes one of the key focuses for us. And you know, let me bring that alive for you. If you imagine that you, you know, are able to detect a cardiac problem in stage one, we all know what the risk factors of cardiac are. If we screen for blood pressure, diabetes, hypercholesterolemia, and stress, you will bring down the incidence. So if you screen, educate, stay connected, that's the primary healthcare system. And if you do that in a manner which is data-led, that's the power of data. And if you build risk profiling, preventive healthcare, that's again the power of data. And at the next layer, if we can do genomic analytics and combine that with this lifestyle, then rather than trying to focus on screening 1.3 billion people, we will create high-risk cohorts and focus on high-risk cohorts. Again, for that, we need data and an integrated system. And each one of these is clinical management, is patient information management, is continuum of care, and it's analytics and AI models at the back end and data science, feeding the people who are in the front line. So it's a combination of these, but the pieces are coming together.
So ma'am, the next leg of our discussion will be on the ZS Prize. And what you think should be the ideal aim of having this kind of an institution of a ZS Prize?
So many years ago, I met the head of Intel when he was visiting India. And he, you know, he was going through a lineup. There was the largest bank, the largest infrastructure company. And then, you know, the introduction came to me. And he said, oh, you're from healthcare. You are the last unconquered bastion of information technology. And of course, you know, healthcare has moved, and you know, I've personally been very committed to the use of technology in healthcare and the Apollo ecosystem. But when you look at innovation and technology, and an India centricity with the focus of accessibility and scale while maintaining quality, I think there's a lot that we can create within those parameters. So as we were discussing earlier, we must find a way for 1.4 billion people to have access to good quality healthcare. We must change the paradigm of a pure treatment-focused healthcare system to a preventive healthcare system. And if you want to do that, then we have to find ways to screen, extensively screen, so testing costs must come down. The methodologies involved in screening. So there's a lot of scope for innovation, for startups, for science, for students. So that, I think, is a big one. Then there's, you know, the high-quality, high-precision work that doctors do. Can we innovate to make their lives easier? What is the workflow? What happens inside an operation theater? Can we integrate from lights? How much voice command can you do for doctors whose hands are, you know, into the patient and operating? Can we do visualization? So virtual reality up on the wall. So the X-ray, the screen, the images come up on the wall while he's operating. So real-time usage of those. Right now, the technologies exist. But do they exist in a cost-effective manner that we can afford to deploy them into our ecosystems? And that really is, you know, one of the areas. So I would say science, and science goes beyond, whether it's, you know, chemical, whether it's biology, nutraceuticals, immunology boosts, the Ayush health system, usage of that, platforms to enhance research and collaboration. There's a range of things. And then there's the whole, you know, mechanical engineering related to healthcare. How can we be smarter in terms of patient transfer systems? Mm-hmm. You know, innovation in integrated planning. Lots of those, I think, would be very powerful as well, because it improves the healthcare ecosystem. And then finally, I go back, you know, to the thing that the healthcare needs to have the patient in the middle and be built and revolve around patient. And from that patient, the information, the intervention, the continuum of care across all the different parts of the healthcare system, whether it's the hospital, the clinic, the lab, the GP, the research, and then go back again to the GP and then come back again to the diagnostic center, each of these in a seamless continuum of care must encompass the patient in a manner that makes it easy for him. And if we design for efficiency and ease, we will automatically cut costs, because, you know, that is in itself intrinsically one of the powers of good and simple design, is that you remove waste. So there's a lot that can be done, and I want to congratulate, you know, the organizers for thinking of healthcare, for focusing on healthcare. I think at no time ever in history has healthcare mm-hmm. been so center stage, so important, and so much on everybody's mind. So it's perfect that this is happening. I hope this is a catalyst for the enhancement and the improvement of healthcare systems at large. And people like us who have been committed to healthcare for a very long time are extremely happy to participate and to support this journey and to accelerate it in any way possible.
Thank you so much for your time, ma'am. And I'm sorry I overshot a little time because...
No, it's fine. It was a pleasure.
Good to hear you.
Wonderful. It was a pleasure and all the very best. Thank you so much, Vikas. Namaste.